Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. By the way, the bump in the bed here is Kenzie. She spends most of her life under a blanket in one room or another. Anyway, today, as promised, I have some glam fall DIYs to share with you. There's definitely some glitter in here. I hope you enjoy. And also, I have a question for you guys. Do you want me to continue doing fall DIYs and fall videos, or do you want me to move on into like Christmas? I've seen some people doing Christmas DIYs and stuff already on YouTube, and I know that some people are looking to get it done early because they sell them at craft fairs or they want to use them as their DIYs as like gift ideas. Let me know your thoughts on that. I hope you will give this video a thumbs up if you find some inspiration, and also subscribe if you haven't already, and let's jump right in. I took one of these ceramic pumpkins from Dollar Tree. I love the smooth matte finish on them because it's really easy to paint. I started by accenting this one with my gold leafing pen. I'm doing one of each, but instead of the gold leafing pen, you could paint the lines with Mod Podge and then add some glitter on here. I already had this big container of gold glitter, but Dollar Tree does have smaller packages of glitter.
I'm driving, you're smiling, just really doing nothing. That's the thing.
A third option is using a little hot glue to add gemstones down the lines of the pumpkins. I added a small one on top as well. I think these are really pretty because they tend to actually kind of reflect the light and colors around them. And a fourth option is painting on some Mod Podge on the top and sprinkling on some glitter to create kind of like a frosted effect on here. I used white glitter, and you could add a glittery leaf on like this. These come on the Dollar Tree fall florals. I found a bunch that had these kind of glittery leaves on there. Just feel free to customize these to fit in with your own decor. This next one is a little silly, but it's still really cute, so I guess I'm gonna share it with you. I was playing around with these coffee note clip signs, and I decided to use Mod Podge around the cup wrapper and then cover that part in gold glitter. And then I took some chalk paint and colored the cup. I also used my gold leafing pen to create some accents on here, like the lid and things like that. And I couldn't decide what I wanted to really do with this, but I ended up coming back also with some brown chalk paint to add a border around the edge of the cup. And I was just thinking of using this to hold either daily reminders on your desk, or perhaps even to hold a cookie flavor label, so guests know what treats you have out on your coffee bar. I don't know, what do you think? Is this cute or silly? For the next one, I used a styrofoam cone from Dollar Tree, and I covered it in the gem vase filler stones just using some hot glue. I left the top part open and cut a $1 bunch of fall roses to arrange on top like a little fall vase, and I think this is just like the perfect piece for styling in a fall vignette on a shelf, in the bathroom, on your nightstand.
I used to stay up all night trying to find my place, chasing neon lights and looking.
The next one is super easy. I decided to cover a glass vase or candle holder with these maple rhinestone sticker sheets. I love seeing the candlelight flickering through, but this could also be an adorable pen holder or flower vase. This next one, I'm using one of the wooden square frame pieces of wall decor that Dollar Tree carries. I took the center decoration out, and you could add some rocks in here if you want. Otherwise, if you don't have the rocks, you can just use hot glue like I was doing to arrange all of your succulents in here how you want them. I'm using a lot of the oranges and purples. And then to decorate the box, I just did a simple box striped pattern design on here, alternating using my gold leafing pen and black oil Sharpie marker. And I feel like this has a very contemporary fall feel. The next one could work well with that. I'm starting with these vase filler decorative spheres from Dollar Tree. These would look so pretty in a centerpiece bowl arrangement. What I'm doing is taking my gold leafing pen and just kind of following the pattern and design on the balls. I think these were looking so awesome, and it's totally my fault, but I had them on the counter drying and we were putting dishes away. My sister was preparing not one, but two different pasta salads for a cookout, and what can I say? Balls roll, right? It was like sadness in slow motion watching them from across the room as they rolled one by one off the counter and smashed on the floor. So don't let that happen to yours, but if you decide to make these, they are pretty easy and inexpensive to make. You can even paint them totally. I tried spray painting some other ones I picked up, white and some gold. I love the way this came out. Also, adding some gold details on top of the white looks really cool as well. They are so elegant and glam, and actually they're perfect for any time of year. So I hope that you guys will enjoy this one if you are looking for some glam decor, maybe to put out for fall, but something you can also leave throughout the seasons. Next, I'm using two wooden craft pumpkin signs from Dollar Tree, along with one of their blue and white patterned placemats. What I did was just trace the outline of the pumpkin and cut it to fit. Make sure you consider which way you want the stem to be facing as well. And then I just cut that out to fit and used Mod Podge to adhere the patterned side to one pumpkin and the blue side to another pumpkin. I'll be totally honest with you, the blue material was a lot harder to work with than the patterned one was, and it kept wanting to shrink and pull in and pull away from the sides once I put the Mod Podge on, so I had a little more trouble with that, but I finally got it positioned pretty well in there, and I just came back with some diamond adhesive bling wrap, and I cut strips of that to outline the pumpkin with so you don't really see the fraying edges anymore. And then once it was dry, I also came back and brushed some Mod Podge down over the pumpkin as if it were frost as well. And I just covered it in gold glitter. I did the stem part as well in here, not 100%. I wanted it to have kind of like a subtle, natural vibe and not be just like perfectly applied, perfectly covered in glitter. I wanted it to just kind of be a little bit more spotty on there and look a little bit more natural. I think that the glam of these pumpkins with the bright royal blue color will go amazing with more modern and contemporary glam home decor styles. And I couldn't stop there with the glitter, so I'm using some of the velvet pumpkins from Dollar Tree. Those are so cool, aren't they? Have you guys seen these velvet pumpkins in your Dollar Tree this year? I finally found them in a couple different colors. They do have a teal one, which would be really cool to add in with your glam fall decor as well. But for these, I have it in the cream color and in the kind of beige taupe colored pumpkin. I'm just brushing a little bit of the Mod Podge over the stem and down, dripping down the side a little bit. And then I covered that in glitter as well. How cool do these look together? For just like a little over a dollar a piece, I think these look really cool, and you get that glittery, frosted effect to your fall decor. I wanted to pop back on here really quick. I was just talking to my aunt about some of these glitter DIYs, and she's like, isn't the glitter going to get everywhere? And yes, it will. You can certainly go back with a sponge brush and some Mod Podge, what we used to put the glitter on in the first place. Go ahead and do another coat or two of Mod Podge and let that dry for like 24 hours, and that should seal your glitter in.
Dollar Tree also carries other little beads and sequins that you can add if you want to get a little bit more of a chunky glitter. This next one was inspired by something I saw recently in Pier 1. I'm just painting one of the Dollar Tree gourds, about a third white, a third pink, and these are chalk paints that I'm using, by the way. And then once that's dry, the bottom third, I came back and I'm doing that with my gold leafing pen, although I think doing multiple of these and then perhaps like reversing the order of the colors for some of them, or even doing some larger pumpkins and some smaller pieces together would look really cool. I guess I'm just obsessed with turning everything gold, but for this next one, I'm using one of these taller wine glasses from Dollar Tree that has the crystal glass etching, and I'm following the patterns and designs in the glass with my gold paint pen and creating some depth and detail on this glass, and then you can arrange some flowers in here, either real ones or fake ones. Another little vase option, Dollar Tree sells these little plastic silver napkin rings in sets of six. This would obviously be only for artificial flowers like this, but I was thinking of making like a trio of them, doing some with four, some with five, and some with six napkin rings, and having like varying heights. I think that would be really cool. And instead of flowers, I have a bunch of these brown berry things from Dollar Tree. I'm just taking some Mod Podge, brushing it on the tops of the berries, like where the frost would naturally fall, and then sprinkling on some glitter to kind of be like the frost again. personally, I was really into the whole gold glitter thing, so that's what I'm using. But I think this turned out really beautiful for costing so little to make. I often feel like I save the best for last, but I think this is one of my favorites. I took one of the Dollar Tree foam pumpkins and I put 3 or 4 coats of a burgundy acrylic paint on here. While the paint is still wet on the pumpkin, I took some pink glitter that I already had on hand, and I actually think it looks pretty good on here. Somehow the pink blends pretty well with the burgundy, and I added on this little candle holder vase thing that I found in Dollar Tree, placing that on top of the foam pumpkin. You can use some glue if you want to go ahead and attach it. I put some of the cinnamon scented pine cones that Dollar Tree has right now into there, and this is just going to be like a little air freshener decoration. You can also swap out the top on here and use this other candle holder I just found in Dollar Tree as well, and put a candle in there instead. I also painted the top edge of this candle holder gold on top and burgundy around the edge to coordinate with the other parts. Let me know if you think it looks better with the pine cones on top or with a votive candle. Anyway, I hope you have enjoyed these DIYs. Definitely know which one is your favorite. I would love to hear from you. I did have a couple other glam DIYs that I wanted to share with you. They were a little bit more complicated. I'm gonna see if they work out. So be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and if you want me to go ahead and try to share those, and then I will share them in a future video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon in the next one. Bye.